Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and I'm here today at the VHU, the Military History Institute in Prague in the Czech Republic. We're taking a look at some developmental Czech machine guns, and what we have here is not quite the first Czech machine gun. That was a gun called the Jelen that was really quite terrible. This is the first machine gun from Vaclav Holek, who would go on to design the ZB-26, possibly one of the best light machine guns ever developed. It was the basis for the Bren gun, and it was adopted in several different forms by a whole bunch of countries. But this is where he started. So what is this? This is, I really want to say this, it's not really quite technically accurate, but I'm going to say it anyway. This is a blow-forward bullpupped Vickers gun. Strictly speaking, that's not accurate, but it definitely gives you the picture of what's here. It's got a couple of windows in it. We're gonna have a great time opening it up and showing you how it works in just a minute. Now, the company that manufactured this was called Zbrojovka Praga, and that basically means Prague Small Arms Factory. Vaclav Holek and his brothers were working for this company, and the development here begins because essentially they heard a rumor that Czechoslovakia was going to start manufacturing French Darn machine guns. In fact, the Czechs did buy Darn guns. They then later also bought Hotchkiss light machine guns. And Zbrojovka Praga, basically what they were hearing was the army's gonna buy machine guns, they're gonna make these French guns. Well, let's make our own machine gun and see if they'll buy it from us. Now, it didn't work with this model, but fast forward a couple of years and we have the ZB-26, and the Czech military, of course, buys those. So. This is developed in 1922. It lasts about 6 months before it's replaced by something else. But you know what? We'll talk about later developments in a minute. First, let's go ahead and just dive right into this and show you how it works. So what we have here is fundamentally the layout is based on a Vickers or Maxim gun. The feed block is very clearly inspired by Vickers and or Maxim. We have what is pretty obviously a water jacket that has been perforated to just be air cooled. There's no good documentation on this, and in fact, all three of the examples that were made, they have photos of here at the VHU, and they all have these ventilated air cooled shrouds, but there's really no reason for this to be here if it wasn't originally at some point going to be a water cooled gun. So we've got that there. The belt that this feeds from is, in fact, just a straight Maxim gun belt. It's chambered for 8x57 German 8mm Maxim. 8mm Mauser, sorry. But there have been a number of changes. So first, most fundamentally, the Vickers and Maxim guns are recoil operated that have sort of a gas booster to them, some more than others. This is entirely gas operated. There's no recoil element to the operating system at all. This is our operating rod, and it's actually functioning on a muzzle blast system. So this cup out here catches muzzle blast when you fire. It gets pushed forward and then, and that provides all of the energy to cycle the action. So nothing inside here is actually recoil operated. So on this side, we have basically the equivalent of a Maxim or Vickers fusee spring. It's most of the operating parts are on the other side of the gun, but we've got the spring over here. And you can see when this cycles, this muzzle cap is gonna go forward. There you can see it coming out. When you fire, instead of me pushing on the handle over here, this operating rod gets pushed forward, which cycles the whole system. Now, the reason that I opened this side first is because that will allow me to remove the main spring. I can set that back down in there. Close the gun, and now we can look at the other side without spring tension. On the way over, just a quick stop to note the manufacturer's mark here, Zbrojovka Praga in Prague, and a serial number. This is gun number 2. Now we can take the cover lever, open that up. I can open up that window and open up that window, and presto, there is the whole gun. All right, so a number of things are going on here. First off, in place of the original toggle lock of the Maxim or Vickers design, now we have a pivoting wedge or pivoting locking block here underneath the bolt. That's the bolt, that's the beginning of the barrel. The chamber is all the way back here, which makes for a very interesting rearward movement during the feed system. If I cycle this here, you can see this locking block is going to pivot down when it's in battery, and as soon as it starts to cycle, again, because when you fire, the muzzle blast pulls forward, which pulls this operating rod forward, which pulls the whole barrel assembly forward, like that. That's the full travel forward of the bolt. And then rearward travel back there. This is essentially a Vickers or Maxim lock that has been taken from being a removable element, a removable assembly, and turned into just a permanent installation in the gun. But we have basically all the same elements of a Vickers lock in there, which is pretty cool. When I pull the trigger, this lever is going to go backward. It's going to hit this lever. This is going to pivot around that pin, which is going to drop this hook, which is going to release this piece, which is the firing pin, which goes forward under tension from this capped spring. That's going to fire the action, which then creates muzzle blast, which is going to cause this to cycle forward. Now, you can see we have this element up here that's also moving back and forth. Coming out here, the feed block is also permanently attached to this front door. This hook is running inside there, and so as the bolt, barrel, etc. moves forward and back, this is going to cam a belt, the belt, inward to feed a cartridge. Now, I can demonstrate a bunch of the feed system using this dummy cartridge. It's going to come in from the feed block over here. It's going to sit right about there. Literally, right there. So the first thing that's going to happen is this hooked catch is going to catch on the rim of the cartridge, and as the bolt, as the barrel travels forward, this is going to travel backward. Like, not like that. All right, until it, sorry, this is a little clumsy to do with the door open. It's meant to have all these pieces compressed together. At the end of its rearward travel, this piece essentially pushes the cartridge onto this spring-loaded hook right here on the back of the bolt. So that's going to catch the rim of the cartridge like that. And now the gun's going to cycle rearward. It continues to pull this cartridge back, so it's been pulled off of the belt at this point. And as it moves towards the back, we have a Maxim style extractor right here. So it slides up and down. It's controlled by, like, all of these parts are controlled in a carefully timed sequence by the forward and backward motion of the action. But as this is coming back, at the end of its travel, this pushes all the way in. The cartridge is going to be snapped up into the extractor slide. Right there. All right, now the next time the gun is fired, that slide is going to pull the cartridge down. Now it's lined up with the chamber right here. The next cycle. There we go. The next cycle chambers that round, locks. As it continues to fire, the next cycle, the round will have fired. Of course, we still have a bullet in there because it's a dummy round. But now the slide drops down. We're going to chamber the next round. And as soon as this starts, the extractor slide starts to go up for the last cycle, it's going to just pop this cartridge off and it ejects out the ejection port in the bottom of the gun. Hopefully that made sense. Essentially, this is the Maxim or Vickers gun cycle. It's just done with a few different elements in place. One neat feature that the Holek gun has that the Vickers does not is this rotating switch. This is a semi-auto selector because this is set up so you can set it to just semi-auto fire. If we look at the inside of the fire control system here, this is in full auto where the trigger is pushed down by this little cam, so it's always in contact with the bottom of the firing sear. If I switch this to semi-auto, the trigger lifts up, and now, right there, you can see, as soon as the action goes forward, the trigger disconnects into this middle slot, and then, when it cycles, it has recocked the striker, but the trigger is still in this empty slot, and I have to release the trigger. Now it pops up, goes to there. What's happening here is this cam is acting as a disconnector right there. It's pushing the trigger down into that. So that's the semi-auto feature. Kind of neat. Vickers guns don't do that. So also worth pointing out here on the bottom of the gun, we have mounting points for the original mount. This was originally put on basically a Schwarzlose machine gun mount. So that's how it was intended to be fired. I will tell you, it has been challenging demonstrating all these parts with the gun on a table because it is heavy and a bit awkward. But there you go. There is your gas-operated, blow-forward, bullpupped, semi-auto-selectable Vickers gun. All right, so like I said, this was developed in 1922. By late 1922, they've already abandoned this. I don't have any information on specific tests or results. We know three of these were made, and two of them, by the way, are still here at the VHU. But the Army wasn't particularly interested in this, and Zbrojovka Praga moves along to, well, eventually they're going to shift from belt-fed to magazine-fed. They're going to shift from something that's fundamentally a heavy machine gun to something that's more of a light machine gun. And we'll have some further videos on later iterative steps in the process towards the ZB-26. But this is the starting point, the first, essentially the first reasonably successful Czech-made machine gun. And was it not super cool? No. I'd like to give a big thanks to the VHU for giving me access to this awesome piece to film for you guys. If you find yourself in Prague, definitely set aside some time. Check out the Army Museum here. It's a really cool museum. It has a whole bunch of really cool Czech prototypes literally up on display, which is rather unusual for military museums these days. So definitely check them out. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.